Hey everyone, welcome back to another Cut Above with Chris. It's Saturday afternoon, just turned Saturday afternoon, and it's my first day back at work since my operation, and I'm looking forward to it. So I'm going to use products tonight, or today, sorry, not tonight, this afternoon, which are pretty much very close to my favourites all round everything. So soap for today, Wickham 1912, and the scent on this one I think is on the tub. It is Club Cola, which smells just to me like fizzy cola bottles, but it does smell a bit like Coca-Cola, but it smells more to me like fizzy cola bottles or cola flavoured sweets and things like that, chews and stuff. So that's what I get from it. The brush for today is the Turn and Shave 30mm Whip Dog Boar. Look at that knot, what a crazy looking knot. There's nothing really uniform about the knot, in all honesty. It's not a... I do like the look of it, but it's not like a beautiful looking knot like, like say, the Morrison Fondrum, where it's just pristine, it's really condensed. It's just a real crazy looking swirly little knot. So straight into the soap. No blooming, none of that rubbish. And let's see how we go. Very surprising bow knot, this. When I got it delivered, I thought it was going to be a really hard, horrible knot to use. But it's actually turned out to be one of my favourite brushes in the den, favourite knots in the den. Overall brush, really, I love this handle. I think Milton over at Turn and Shave absolutely killed it with the handle. I was going to use my massive Razor Rock Hulk, which was also kindly sent to me. Well, this wasn't sent to me, this was purchased, but which was kindly sent to me. But just as an extra homage to Milton over at Turn and Shave, who did his anniversary release a couple of days ago and sold out all his brushes in 3 minutes. 10 brushes, I think it was $25 shipped, I think something like that, $28 shipped, and they all sold out pretty much instantly. 3 minutes for 10 brushes. Right, so brush is caked, gonna wet the face. Now, as it's a little bit colder here at the moment, I'm just blasting out a hot water shave, or a cold, warm water shave, should I say. It's not actually that hot, I didn't let it get too hot. All the soap that's on my face right now, I suppose the load, I think people call it proto lather, which is like fake lather, I suppose. I used to throw this, I used to just rinse it away at the end of the shave. I never ever gave it a thought to use it until I started watching people using it in the shaves. I thought, oh, what a great idea. So as you can see, very, very thick, pasty load in the brush. Dipping at a time. And again. And again. It's a strange brush. Just rubbing that on my lips here, I get a sort of a bit of roughness, a bit of scrub from it. Almost a bit of scritch. Okay. and then when you do that, it's gone. Larry over at Whip Dog, I don't know who does his knots, where he gets them from, or whether he makes them himself. But his bow knots are exceptional. As you can see, the backbone's just right for me. It's got just the right amount of scrub for me. I mean, at the end of the day, it doesn't really matter what natural hairbrush I use. I can't get three ladders from one natural hairbrush that I can get from a synthetic. In terms of volume, and actually getting a massive creamy ladder every single pass, which isn't required. It's just a thing I enjoy doing. So there we go, the brush is caked. Karve Razor, fifth use on the Gillette, the spoiler. Which I have been told can get you up to 20 plus shaves from one blade. Shave number five. And I can tell you right now, it's really smooth. I'm just trying a little bit different there, coming up from the bottom, because my hair sort of grows in that direction. Apologise about the TV being so loud, bloody kids. First pass down, lovely jubbly. Slickness on Wickham is lovely. The soap quality is lovely. Don't know what Spencer's talking about. I've never actually struggled with Wickham, ever. I don't think I've ever had a bad lather. Maybe way back in the beginning. Right, pass number two. the hair there, but I don't. Now this blade is a vintage blade, it's from the 70s. So it's, I think roughly, it's about 11 years older than me, this one in particular I'm shaving my face with. I wish I was in good a condition as this blade is. These blades were obviously made at a time. Where quality mattered, big time. Instead of quantity. And the thing is, even back then, I know guys would have taken blades to the limit. There would have been a lot more double-edged razor shavers back in the sort of, between the 20s and the 60s and the 70s and things like that, I would imagine. I'm not quite sure when the sort of first cartridge razors took over. I know they when they came out roughly, but when they actually started taking over and people started changing. Oh, I love the scent of this. As you can see, a much thinner lather for the third pass. The knot doesn't hold anywhere near the sort of lather that you get from a big synthetic or even a big badger. I think part of it being because it's not a densely packed knot, like say it's a little bit juddery, it's unusual. Strangely enough, it doesn't feel like it's got its usual Wickham slickness. Don't you be laughing at this, Spencer. Still one hell of a shave. Right, done and dusted. Three passes and a little clean up around the lips. Felt great. The warm water was actually quite nice for a change. Brush clean now. Yeah, sort of lost a little bit of slickness at the end there. I don't know what was going on. It's almost like the slickness has just sort of disappeared. So it just goes to show you, no matter how many times you've used the same soap, sometimes you can get a different experience from it. That was definitely unexpected. So there we go. That is the knot there after use. You can see it sort of start to bloom out a little bit. I don't know how far it will bloom over use. It needs a bit more use, obviously. I've only used it like 6 times or something. So after, so I would say sort of maybe 20, 30, 40 times, I'd like to see, but I think it'll start blooming just a little bit. Obviously, it's such a short loft, it'll only spray so far, or bloom out so far. And I'm just going to finish off now with some Club Cola aftershave balm, which is the Mutt's Nuts. Oh yeah. Now, one thing I am sort of noticing with a couple of my Wickham products, including this one, the scent's still amazing, but it's not as strong as it was when I bought it. I mean, it's still there, it's around about a 4, 3.5, 4. I think when I bought that, it was quite a bit stronger. So it's, I don't know how this is going to last. I mean, I've used a fair bit of this. I'm probably halfway through it, I would say. But the scent's still there. The balm is the same. I've noticed the balm's lost a little bit of its vigour. It's not quite in your face as it was before, but it could be that the stuff inside the little straw, but I don't know. But the post-shave feel on it is phenomenal. Absolutely brilliant. So the soap today was Wickham 1912, as you can see there, Club Cola, which is a lovely fizzy cola bottle sort of scent. The brush which I've just shown you a minute ago was the Turn and Shave 30mm Whip Dog Boar, which is a stunning brush, stunning knot, one of my favourites, very close to being my favourite in the den. And then we've got the razor, I'm just going to clean off the top cap. And I hope I can sort of show you a little bit of the patina starting. Probably not, but hopefully you can maybe just make that out where the sort of darker marks are on the top cap. It's not, in fact, you can probably see it right on the edge there. Just on the edge there next to the blade on the top cap. It is slowly on its way, very slowly. I do dry this and clean it, polish it every time I use it, so obviously I'm taking the water off, I'm taking the oils off, and it's all those sort of things that assist in getting the patina to happen. Now I just wanted to mention something. I've took the head off, so there is the handle. Can we get that to focus? There we go, focused. That's the handle there. Now this is actually in 3 pieces. I was quite amazed how it actually works. So this little butt cap here is 1 piece, this is the 2nd piece, and then obviously your main shaft here is your 3rd piece. And what actually happens is the holes on this are slightly smaller than the two rods that are attached to both end pieces. So there's a rod that goes inside the main handle here, and they're slightly wider, and it's 0.02 mils, I think. So very, very small fractions. And then what happens is this is then placed into a, I can't remember what it's called, but like a crusher. And what it does is it pushes on both ends and actually squashes them solid together. So there's no glue holding this together. You would never know. I'm not joking when I say this. I look at this razor quite often, looking at it, I'm amazed. It looks like a solid piece of brass. You cannot pick that's 3 bits of brass stuck together. And it is absolutely flawless. But I was amazed how it was actually made. So it's held together with the force of the brass pushing down on the two little sort of sleeves, collars that are going in there. Very, very, quite an amazing thing to know. It's interesting to find out whether they're all like that, whether all the handles for like Wolfman and stuff and Timeless and all that are actually made in 3 pieces like that, or if this is his unique way of doing it, I don't know. But it's absolutely flawless, it just blows me away. The blade in there, as you can see, is the Gillette Super Stainless, the spoiler. And as you can see on that side here, without slicing my fingers open, 4 dots. So that was my 5th shave, there's 4 shaves already on it. So I'll pop another dot on there, and let's say that's another super smooth, super comfortable, extremely minimal irritation shave, and I really, really enjoyed it. Warm water as well, which was nice. It was a little bit of a change. I might actually do a bit of more warm water shaves. It was really nice, I enjoyed that. Yeah, very, very nice. Stay safe, drive safe, don't drink and drive, and I'll catch you guys after my next shift. Cheers.